sure I have space in my inventory. Oh, look, it's the miner. Yeah, that's what their names would be, by the way. What an interesting vehicle to drive to catch up to someone. Geez, the music keeps having to restart. But now, anyways, we've got the thing, the diamonds. So now we can use that to once again pay off the Runaway Five's debt. I wonder how many times we're gonna have to do that, though. we'll be done at Forza, and then we'll go to the next major area, and then when we get there, we'll find out that the Runaway Five have been playing gigs at the local theater, but they are in debt again. Buy another ticket? Ugh, that's a little annoying. Not entirely necessary. I wonder, would I be able to just use my backstage pass? I'm gonna store something with the Express, and then I'm just gonna see if I can just use my backstage pass from the Chaos Theater, and if that works, hooray, but if not, I'm just gonna buy a ticket. Why are you talking to my back? Look, I actually got through dialogue boxes without screwing up somehow. Freeze state here. And then oh, it's a cranky lady. Correction, extra cranky lady. Oh right, it's in Jeff's inventory. Nah, it won't work. Oh, I don't think... I think I lost that cranky lady fight now. Whatever. Magic butterfly, not that I need it. Honestly, maybe I should have stayed at the desert and leveled up Paul a little. Just because she's so close to another level. I'm trying to figure out what that line means. The police would say, "Hey, you guys." So if the Runaway Five just sort of ditch their contract, the police would just start shouting at them, and that's all they do. Here you go, Ms. Fake. I can't remember if it was mentioned, but that's her name. $50. And here they come to make their big... big... leave... big... I can't think of the right word. Ah! Have to drag the saxophone guy off. She's falling in love with her diamond. So they're gonna do one last show, huh? Let's go watch. And there's that mystery piano guy again. Hello, mystery piano guy. Guest performance. That would be Venus, the singer, who's also at the theater. Someone mentioned her earlier. They just all, the three of them just drove off. Yeah. Luckily, more than a few people have mentioned her. We've met her mom in Tucson. And luckily for us, we don't have to pay off her debt as well. I don't think she even always has a debt to pay. Okay, so... Venus doesn't. Yeah, so, some point between the point where they got in their car and drove it off the stage, I guess Venus got out and went to the dressing room or something. Darn. I wanted to throw my stinky socks at him. Oh, these people weren't here before. What a strange couple. Jeez. I just went to see the show and I can buy myself another ticket. Huh? Well, with that, we've helped out the Runaway Five yet again. Don't ask me why they don't seem to be thanking us or anything anymore. They just seem to disappear, I mean. Like, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. Urgh. No! Thank you. Anyways, that of course leaves the question, now what? We've helped out the Runaway Five, and now we just seem to be... we have no clear goal anymore. Well, as it turns out, once you help out the Runaway Five, for some reason that causes the department store to open up again, and that's where you're supposed to go next. As you may or may not remember, you probably do if you've been watching this, when we first checked out the Foresight department store, it said it was closed, and then there was this weird noise followed by some creepy music.